Welcome to Aryabhatt Center for Theoretical Physics. This is another video on the lecture series called Mechanics 2. And in this video, I am going to talk about the Lagrangian and momentum. In classical mechanics, we take space and time homogeneous substance. It means space and time both are homogeneous. It means if we look the space around any classical system, it will look same, and time is universal parameter in the classical mechanics. So if time is homogeneous, then we can derive one of the most fundamental conservation law in mechanics called conservation of energy, which I have explained the in the last lecture, that out of the homogeneity of time there is a conservation law called conservation of energy. Same way, out of homogeneity of space, or if we take space as homogeneous, then it will automatically lead to conservation law, which is called conservation of momentum. And what do you mean by space is homogeneous? It means the mechanical property of any closed system are unchanged if we if we parallel displace the entire system. It means if there is a r position vector, and if we replace r plus sin l, very small displacement, then the property of that mechanical system will remain the same. Let us consider that sin l is very infinitesimal displacement, or very small displacement, and in this case Lagrangian will remain unchanged. And now we are replacing radius vector r of any mechanical system with r plus sin l. So now we can say that the change in Lagrangian of that system is del L by del R A dot del R A. This is the overall change in the Lagrangian of that system. And here there is an incremental displacement called sin L. So del R A will be replaced by sin L, and we will get this one. And we know that there is no change in overall Lagrangian of that system when we do very small displacement in the mechanical system. It means del L is equal to 0. It means this whole thing will become 0. Del L by del R A summation is equal to 0. So this is the first equation. Now we know that Lagrangian, this is the Lagrangian equation, d by dt del L by del V A equal to del L by del R A, and this one is nothing but a momentum. It means dp by dt is equal to del L by del R A, and here d by dt del L by del V A is equal to d by dt del by del V A equal to 0, because according to the first equation this term is 0. So we will get simply this term as momentum. It means p is equal to del L by del V A. It means momentum is conserved for the closed system. And if we replace p is equal to mv, this is the standard formula for the momentum, and here in this case we have derived momentum of any classical system or closed system is 0, and this is due to the homogeneity of space. Now from the equation 1, this one, we will lead to del L by del R A is equal to minus del U by del R A. It means change in potential energy, rate of change of potential energy is also force acting on the eighth particle or nth particle, or you call can call it eighth particle. It means total force acting on eighth number of particle in closed system is zero. It means F1 plus F2 is equal to zero, and you can see that this is the standard Newtonian second law. It means every force acting on any object will be repelled by same amount of the force. This is the Newtonian second law, and here is the generalized momenta. Generalized momenta P is equal to del L by del Q dot. This is the formula for generalized momenta, and there is a generalized force Fi is equal to del L by del Q I, and rate of change of momentum is called force, and this is the Lagrangian moment Lagrangian equation for the momentum. F is equal to P dot or dP by dt. So we can say that due to the homogeneous nature of space in classical mechanics, this homogeneous nature of space will lead to conservation law called conservation of momentum, and we can derive through using the Lagrangian of any closed system by making incremental displacement from r to r plus sin l, and if we calculate, we will lead to the conservation of momentum. And the previous lecture I have explained that due to the homogeneous nature of time, we can derive conservation law of energy. So these two important conservation law due to the homogeneous nature of space and time in classical mechanics. Now in the next video I will solve few problem in Lagrangian, or I will calculate Lagrangian of any mechanical system, as well as few problem related to momentum.